I just wish that I could sing. Hello everyone, welcome to the Mod Show, and look, every week is amazing now, so get ready for a lot of fun and a lot of cool little additions. But before we get started, always remember, MODS! Oh! Put the lion down! Weird!
Shit, it's a Gore Magala hammer.
It's a Gore Magala hammer! Firstly then, a little splash of colour. And ta-da! Here you go.
Does he do anything different?
No, it's just pink.
It wouldn't be the first time. I like it.
<It's cool. laughs> I have that face of someone who's just like unwrapped it and they've gone, yeah, and I'm like, oh god, they hate it.
I mean, it's just like, it literally looks like you poured a bucket of pink paint on him. Like, you can still see his original color scheme.
I missed a spot.
Yeah, you missed a few spots.
Look, man, say. I'm trying, okay?
It's the thought that counts.
Exactly! And I thought you'd like pink Dodo. So this is known as cute Dodo Gamma.
Well, it's not an incorrect description of the color.
But the thing is, Dodo Gamma is cute even without being pink, so.
Yeah, but you know, it's enhanced.
Whoa! Something does not get more cute just by being pink.
Yes, it does.
No, it doesn't.
Yes, it does.
Why are you saying that like it's a law of the universe? An inarguable truth.
The law of my universe.
Okay. All right. Well, what about a gorilla?
Pink gorilla would be super cute.
Okay. Okay. The alien.
Which one?
The alien.
Which one?
Alien. There's only one alien.
No, there isn't.
Alien.
Even if you're talking about the movie Alien, that's an entire race of aliens. So which one? Because you're being fucking racist here, Josh. Which alien?
Fucking xenomorph, ding dong.
Which xenomorph? Is it Steve? Is it Frank? Like, come on, man.
Does it matter? They're all the same.
It's like you saying the human. Like, come on, man.
They're fucking alien killing machines. Who gives a shit?
Wow, that was super uncool of you, man.
But would they look cute pink?
Yes.
Okay, you make strong arguments to your pink case. Admittedly, there's not much to say about this one. It's a kind of painted pink Dodo Gamma, but you know, sometimes you just want to take something and you just want to make it pink. And if that happens to be a dodo who's already adorable, well, you know I am going to be all about that, as you all should be too. And of course, remember, it is a dodo, so there's only one way to handle this properly. Oh wait, I'm going to get a rock, so I definitely don't kill him.
I swear, if he dies... I mean, of all the places you could have fucking shot a rock, you shot it in his fucking head. Like, what's wrong with you?
That's all that was there!
He only had a head!
He did! He only had a head!
His entire body. And his whole body.
Oh, he holds you.
The cutest part of it. He always holds me. We have an understanding.
Also, holded.
Holded.
We'll be right back. Got Magala. He's a star, yeah. And I'm not gonna do this. I'm sorry. But the weapons are in, and they are just sexy as hell. They have always been some of the nicer looking weapons, so it's awesome to take these for a spin and ah! What the fucking piece of shit, Radaban! I am trying to So you got the hunting horn, the greatsword, and the hammer as you saw, but I would say probably the nicest, or at least one of the most well-known Gore Magalas, is the insect glaive, and it does look very, very delicious. Don't lick it, though, because you will get infected with a deadly virus. It tastes like cherry, but it will weaken your immune system, and you'll probably die to a paper cut. But that's okay! Just don't lick your fucking stuff. Where am I going with this? They look great, they're spot on, and it literally is just, yeah, this is probably how Gore Magala weapons would look if Gore Magala is in the game, and that is a level of quality that is damn impressive. So, well done, Mr. Inquez. Behold!
I don't have this mod.
Are you sure?
You didn't give me this mod.
Are you sure? What do you see?
Yes. I see a Teostra and a Lunastra.
Where's the Lunastra?
Oh my god.
Behold!
Nope.
No.
The Teostra is blue!
No.
And the Lunastra is red!
Inconceivable!
No.
What do you mean, no?
No.
Have you never thought to yourself, what if Teostra was blue and Lunastra was red?
No.
So, yeah, just essentially a color swap Teostra-Lunastra pairing. Like, it's stupid, but why not, right? I feel like one of the biggest core principles of modding is such a healthy dose of why not? The only sad thing for me is their fire colors aren't swapped. I'd kind of like Lunastra flames in red and Teostra's in the purpley blue just to complete the whole look, but it's just something a bit silly and a bit fun and just a tiny bit.
Why?
So, get ready for this next one, guys. You ever felt like the Odogaron armor is one of the best sets in the game? Well, you should, because it is. But you ever felt like there's too much to it? You want to get rid of all the non-straps, but maybe this is still too much. Better. Is this the Odogaron armor that you want? Well, that's okay, because we can take it even further. Now. Because sometimes you just want to take the Odogaron armor and essentially remove nearly every part of it. And you might be wondering, can this go even further? Can this? Well, to you, my friend, I have only one thing to say.
FBI, open up!
On to the main event! Main event! That's extra funny with it. You'll see. Do people rob places in Monster Hunter with slingers? Like, get down! Everybody get down!
Why?
Because it's like a gun Oh no, light bow guns and heavy bow guns.
Yeah, okay, I won't bother bringing it out then. You worked it out on your own. That's the important part.
All right, man, look, I know I've said this for a while, but we do have a new best mod. All right, here we go. Let me introduce you to the best Teostra has ever been.
Okay. Why is his face not connected?
It's Mufasa.
I think that's Simba, man.
Is it? I don't know. They're all lions.
I think that's Simba. Man, why are you such a racist? First aliens, now Simbas.
Only to lions and aliens and alien lions. Look at it.
Oh, I'm only racist towards certain races. That's not very racist.
Shut the fuck up. That's not what I mean. How gloriously done is this, though? Attached and animated properly in a way that makes sense. Like, his tail sweep is accurate.
Yeah, it's the animated girl, but they chose a model that actually fits.
Yeah, exactly. And, you know, made adjustments to make that happen. He looks really silly when he's just floating, though.
Well, no, he's just in the middle of Hakuna Matata.
Okay. Put that lion down.
No. I am so powerful that I can fly and hold up this lion.
Oh, it's not the lion that's flying and
No. I'm holding him up.
Okay. This, then, is, well, it is just a masterpiece. It is one of the most technically competent mods so far. A custom model rigged properly with the animations that work. Yes, Teostra is, well, liony shaped, so that is an advantage, but it's not just slap on a model. The mouth opens properly, the fire comes out of it, the tail swish is accurate. He actually feels fightable. There's no phantom limbs floating in the air or weird hitboxes. It's just Teostra as a lion, and it functions. So you look at the fact that we've got custom animations and attacks on the way, we've got custom models working this well, I mean, it's just a matter of time until we end up in a world of something truly special. Well, this is giving you your dream of being able to fight a lion with a big hammer.
I don't have that dream.
Well, not anymore, you've crossed it off your dream list.
I don't have a dream list. You realize most people have one dream, right? Like, there's no list. You're getting real greedy at that point if you have a dream list.
Well, it's like backup dreams, isn't it?
I'd like to win the lottery, but that, you know, that's a slim chance. So I'd also like to just, you know, be happy, but that'll never happen. I'd like to...
Why is winning the lottery above happiness?
Well, you know, money can buy happiness if you like the right things.
If you like the right things.
Well, if you like money, then you'll be real happy with money, won't you? I guess for that person, winning the lottery and happiness are the same goal, aren't they?
Your logic is impeccable.
I know, I have some pretty good pecs.
Put the lion down!
No! He must fly! Hakuna Matata, motherfucker!
Tell my sword you'll be king one day. Hakuna Matata, motherfucker. It's like if Simba went the wrong path and did lion drive-bys.
Okay, this essentially, this is like, alright, Teostra's a lion. I'm gonna make Teostra a lion. Like, I can appreciate the technical fidelity, but like,
I was thinking in the back of my mind, but I didn't want to say anything. Wait, Teostra is kind of a lion, right?
Like, literally, like, the imaginative side of this one is slightly lacking as far as I'm concerned.
Well, he's the best candidate to become a lion.
Oh, no shit!
So, yeah, admittedly, there's not much more to say when it comes to this, just how well done it's done by a Mr. Uber Grainy, who has done a lot of good in the past, and he is only getting better. He was the one behind the Thomas the Tank and the Poogie Moth, but I think we could all agree this is a step in the right direction. It might not be as comical, though there definitely is something to it, but it's just nice to see it so functioning and so well. It kind of makes me wonder what the other monsters would work like as just straight animal swaps. Like, you just make Great Jagras a literal Komodo dragon, for example. I would kind of like to see that, an almost, well, real animal swap in, swap out of the monster roster, and that would feel kind of interesting to fight, almost a little bit wrong because you're used to what the real animals can do, but then they're doing all of this. And maybe this is just me. I realize it's probably... I just want to slaughter a load of animals with a big sword, guys! But yeah, 10 out of 10. Absolutely in love with this lion Simba Teostra swap. It means great things for the future, and oh god, it's just a matter of time until we have all the old monsters. He's gotta be a limpy lion. Oh yeah, he is a limpy lion.
It's not a thing I want you to say anymore.
Limpy lion?
Yeah, that's the one.
Does it not do it for you?
Doesn't do anything for me.
Limpy lion.
I said it doesn't do anything for me.
Limpy lion.
You're making it worse.
Limpy lion!
That's a little better.
Limpy Lion!
No.
Oh. Limpy Lion.
That's the voice that Pink Yonagama should have had.
Oh, he died to the tail.
Circle of life.
I like him. I think he's
Who's
fun.
The king now, bitch? As we carve off his chin.
You died harder than your father.
What the fuck?
So yeah, there you go, guys. That is your main mods for the day. Still funny to me, really. And yes, we have the Link Master Sword and Shield, which looks really, really nice. I mean, dead on, it just works beautifully, so that's pretty damn snazzy too. And that one is by Mr. Ezekiel, another recurring quality name. So I will leave you there, everyone. I hope you've had fun. I hope 2019's treating you okay so far. And I will see you soon. Like, enjoy, this, subscribe for more. A good bye.
Rage gaming with the video float.
But that's all that's really relevant at the mo, but I'm still gonna leave this up so you patrons know that I love you even though the outro's no longer that kinda relevant. But the new one's being worked on and it's gonna be a truly badass song, and don't worry, I won't be doing any rapping on it. I'm gonna go now. This was shit.
Sick dodge.
Wow, I thought I just knocked you into the lion. Well dodged. Don't just walk away like you're proud of yourself.
I was hoping it was gonna end in like a couple seconds after I started doing that, but it's like... sort of awkwardly still going. Like,
hey man, where you going? Oh god, my eyes!